Solutions. Students can be taught about the importance of investing. The key to a safe and sound future is knowing when and where to invest. Donations can help in a great way. We can donate books to a poor child or buy groceries for a poor family for a week. We can also help as individuals by funding a poor child's education or by influencing others to do so. Raising money can help as well.
Solutions. Food serving techniques in hostel can be rethought to cut down food wastage. Each student should be thankful for the nourishment they get and must try their level best to reduce food wastage. We, as a class, could work with the local food pantry to develop creative ideas for distributing leftover food from restaurants and grocery stores to people who will put it to good use. Students can use social media or create posters to educate and raise awareness, encouraging people to be more thoughtful about how they're treating food.
Solutions. If you take care of your mind, you take care of the world. So a session on the importance of mental health can be conducted by the students to raise awareness. Usage of plastic in the school premises can be minimized. Fountain pens can be used instead of one-time use pens as they tend to last longer and can minimize wastage.
Share the workload at home. Sharing domestic responsibilities ensures that the work burden doesn't fall only on one person and instills the values of gender equality and essential life skills in children.
Offering bus seats while traveling to an elderly person, no matter the gender, or a pregnant woman can inspire those around you to respect everyone equally.
Avoid making assumptions about anyone's ability, profession, or personality based on their gender.
Organize a cleanup project for rivers and oceans. Engage your whole community to clean up a local river, seaside, or an ocean.
Rainwater harvesting is definitely the easiest way to ensure we get enough clean water. Collecting rainwater and storing it can help a lot.
25% of rural India has no sanitation facilities. Providing sanitizers, soaps, etc. to rural homes using donations seems like a great plan and can be worked on if you do enough research. Don't use multiple devices at the same time. Be mindful about this and only use several devices when absolutely necessary.
Investing in solar, wind and thermal power, improving energy productivity and ensuring energy for all is vital.
There are alternatives for everything. The introduction of electric powered vehicles are going to help out a lot in the future and can act as an alternative for petrol and diesel.
Organize a mentoring program. Invite people with experience in a certain field to create a mentoring group that will help young people better prepare for the future.
Reporting child labor whenever we come across it can help more children get educated.
Solutions for goal number 9. Right ambience for quality education, like well-equipped laboratories, well-stocked libraries, spacious courtyards, etc. Introduce solar panel and rainwater harvesting in schools to encourage an environmentally responsible attitude in the next generation. Publish weekly newspaper in schools to share the innovative ideas of teachers and students. An active student-teacher interactive form to the increased bonding between them. Conduct inter-school book fest, food fest, etc. To gain practical knowledge of a real working environment, we can have industrial visits. Solutions for goal number 10. Give equal opportunities for all the students for attending competitions instead of favoring particular students. help the students with special needs, just like the normal students, to bring out their talents and to boost their confidence. Create campaigns in schools with the supervision of teachers, which helps the students to understand the importance of equality and make themselves a better human being from the school where their foundation is being built. Solutions for goal number 11. Keep a light hour on the monthly basis in which, for a particular time, the entire electricity of the school would be shut down. Organize a competition or a weekly task for the students to recycle plastic on their own creativity, which could also be a good resource for school purposes. Make a class garden. At least one period of each classes on a monthly basis to be conducted in a school compound outside the class.
Good morning. Today I'm going to speak about Sustainable Development Goals 13. So what is SDG 13? SDG 13 is about climate action and is one of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals established by the United Nations in 2015. What are the solutions to SDG 13? Companies can contribute to this SDG by decarbonizing their operations and supply chains through continuously improving energy efficiency, reducing the carbon footprints of their products, services and processes, and setting ambitious emissions reductions targets in line with climate science, as well as scaling up investment in the development of innovative low carbon products and services. Thank you.
Sustainable Development Goal 14 is all about the conservation of life under the water, as in oceans, river bodies and other local water bodies. We can conserve them in few steps. Firstly, reducing marine pollution, as in plastics. We should be more careful when we use plastics and we should dispose them in a correct manner. Even if you don't want to, these plastics can end up in the ocean and lead to the depletion of the life in the oceans. Secondly, it's ocean acidification, and these over-excessive use of fertilizers and pesticides on the fields can end up through the water bodies and into the ocean, which creates a not so friendly environment for the fish to live in. Thirdly is a controlled fishing. We shouldn't fish on trolling times. Trolling times are times when the fish are meant to breed in order to increase their population, and it is banned to fish at those times, and people still do fish for their personal gains on these times and should be stopped. These are some ways to keep in mind while we live on this earth.
My suggestion on goal number 15, life on land, is that we can plant a fruit or a vegetable seed in a pot and place it in every classroom. And the students of the respective classroom have to look after the plant. This practice will improve a child's responsibility and also his care for nature and much more. We also get fresh fruits and vegetables and can make our campus an eco-friendly one.
Hi, I'm Kyle. I'm here to talk about Sustainable Goal number 16, Peace, Justice and Strong Institutions. That is one of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals established by the UN in 2015. SDG 17, which promotes peaceful and inclusive societies for sustainable development, provide access to justice for all and build effective and accountable inclusive institutions at all levels. Goal 16. The goal has 10 outcome targets. Reduces violence, protects children from abuse, exploitation, trafficking, violence, promote rule of law, ensures equality, access to justice, combat organized crime, illicit financing and armed flows, substantially reduce corruption, bribery, develop an effective and accountable and transparent institutions, ensure responsive and inclusive and respective decision making, strengthen participation of global governance, provides universal legal identity, ensures public access to information, protect fundamental freedoms. So as students, what can we do for ST16? Crowdfunding. As students, it is possible to raise funds by conducting school-authorized fundraisers or setting precedent. We could have a mock court in our school to implement a strong justice system that could bring peace within the school and can give students a chance to learn about the justice system for the future. Thank you, and that's me.
We, the students of Excelsior English School, were giving goal number 17, that is, Partnership for the Goals. This goal is very important as it incorporates the other 16 goals. The global goals can only be achieved if we work together. This includes cooperation between governments and private institutions, along with forming of new policies between different countries, strengthening the means of implementation, and revitalizing the Global Partnership for Sustainable Development is what SDG 17 aims at. What can we as students do to achieve this goal? We can support export by buying products from developing countries, accompanying NGOs who are working towards achieving the sustainable goals, staying informed through news, and keeping yourself updated about the sustainable development goals. Through collaboration, teaching students of underdeveloped or developing countries, we can create awareness among the students. Cultural education also helps a lot. Development is something that we cannot exclude. At the same time, it is important for us to safeguard the environment and the rights of every human. I conclude by quoting Mother Teresa. I alone cannot change the world, but I can cast a stone across the water to create many ripples. Thank you.